Oh, States, so that's been nice. Sitting next to Tristan is his cousin, Guri. I should say Tristan is 74, Guri is 81 years old. The two of them have been singing together since they were children. They learned folk songs from their families, from their parents, grandparents. They teach their songs to their children and their grandchildren. Tristan sings in the church choir with his grandson, in fact, in his village. So they're very closely connected to their culture and their traditions. And Mira up here, he's the newcomer to the trio. In fact, it was only 6 years ago that they put their trio together. And Merab makes part of his living as a restaurant musician, in addition to all of his folk music activities. He plays tenor sax.
Oh.
But they are some of the finest singers in Georgia today, and it's a great pleasure to have them here. We're going to continue with a song which has a text from a 19th century poem glorifying the creator. It features this instrument, which is called the chonguri. It comes from Western Georgia. It's something like a banjo, but not exactly. It has a drone string that's halfway up the neck. That's what makes it kind of like the banjo, but otherwise, it's nice. Decision to translate the Bible into Georgian language and to create a liturgy which was in their own language so that it would be accessible and friendly to all of the people. So one of the things that they did, at least this is speculation, but it seems pretty likely to me, is that they created three-part church hymns which were similar to the folk music that they were already singing. And the oldest evidence that we have from of this three-part singing in the church predates the emergence of polyphonic singing in Europe. It goes back to about the 9th century. So, we're going to give you a traditional sacred hymn from the Orthodox liturgy. This is a hymn to the Virgin Mary, Shenkhavana. You in the toast, so not just welcoming you to the table, but they want to know if it's a toast to peace. What do you think about peace? What would you like to say about peace? And in the spirit of inclusion, We are now going to sing a song all together. And as they remind me, every time we have a concert, they can't sing the song without your help. So I know we have a ready and willing audience, certainly over in that direction. So all you have to do is sing. The words are hey wa di la.
Hey wa di la.
And you sing that twice on two different tones. It's like this. Hey wa di la.
Hey wa di la.
Once again, a step down.
Hey wa di la.
We're all set.
Hallelujah.
Shalva Chemo, and it's the song for which the trio is named. There happens to be a friend of ours here in the audience who is named Shalva. So they were dedicating the song to him here. The text comes from a 19th century poem, and it's talking about a person named Shalva. What a sweet person he is, sweeter than life itself. So,
Oh,
Georgia is full of artists, and they love art. The next song is a song about art, and how art is something that is important in our lives, and something that cannot be taken away from us. And my favorite line is the last couplet in the song, which translates roughly as, the person who has no knowledge, meaning specifically knowledge of art, but knowledge in general, is an annoyance to the world.
How's that see yourself?
Blue.
featuring the Gurian. This is called Do You Remember My Love When We Met in the Garden. And that was actually the event that sponsored these three singers as well as a group of dancers to come over and perform. So if it hadn't been for Darajan and the festival, these men would not be here tonight. So thanks very much. Today. They sing in a couple of different groups up there, Georgian music. These three men have been singing Georgian songs for a long time. There are lots of people around singing Georgian music, so thanks to all those people who keep this wonderful tradition alive. And if you want to find out more about it, you can talk to me or to Glenn. Kartuli Ensemble rehearses in Kingston, not so far away. We do have some CDs available if you're interested in taking some of what you hear home tonight. I especially encourage you to get their CD, which you will not find on iTunes. Not yet, anyway. So we'll close the program with a hunting song. This is Shalva Chemo, the Black Thrush, and it's the Hunter listening to the voice of the bird, telling him some information about where the deer went, and apart from the voice of the bird, you might hear the voice of the dog as well.
Oh,